Board, season end, trip to the beach with widescreen on the windscreen. On the map, it looks a feasible, picturesque road. Due north, pop up from Cannes on the Côte d'Azur, though cunning is required with waypoints later on. Movie festival to Merivale. It's baroque splendour ever increasing and tedious in traffic. Parallel to the Route de Grand Alpe, the Napoleonic route. After his jailbreak, a beautiful young woman hitchhiking on the side of a fairly quiet road, just as I have so many times, particularly through university. It would be churlish not to stop and offer her a lift. That's without picking her up or offering her a ride all the way. The more personal details I gave her, the more forthcoming she was with the where personal details about herself. She's off back to see her parents in a village off the old Napoleonic Road, up through the Alpes Maritimes. She had qualified as a doctor and found a job doing what she trained and qualified to do in Italy, in Milan. She felt comfortable there in Mediterranean culture, not so far from where she grew up. Responsibility and promotion prospects were likely better. She was making a difference in a career that, as a woman, was not followed so seriously by so many Italian women. And the established consultants were always so welcoming and pleased to see her and be working with her. She had met a guy in a cafe that she goes to regularly. I think she may have said waiter. Yes. I wished I hadn't asked. She was still at the long hours of work, eat, sleep, phase. Italians have more balance, apparently. I didn't question that her learning curve must be more limp. La peau douce dans mes bas de pouce, je m'éclabousse, j'en ris. Tout comme le souvenir de son sourire, j'en garde des séquelles, mais je sais qu'elle sait que son silence est d'or, mais d'or, alors je me tais. Vas-y, Charlotte, le silence est d'or.
Un peu de silence. premier rapport, elle me fit du mal. J'étais le mâle, et la femelle fait mal. Dieu sait qu'elle, c'est qu'elle, c'est qu'elle. Assis des pistelles, la citronnelle. La miss me laisse par son acte con. J'ordonne l'abscisse, mais cela reste abscon. J'ai un esprit sain, dans un corps très sain, j'ai fait le bien. Mais elle est allée voir plus loin.
He had taken the route many times, and so perhaps was why I seemed a little less distracted by the conversation that had flowed. Two thirds more about her, which is all.
Je l'invite au jeu, lui dit.
Always a good balance. When it came to the turn off for her village, a few kilometres on ahead, she warned. I was starting to think that we would just naturally go on forever. As it turns out, it's just that Napoleon road that seems to go on forever.
J'ai pas de problème, je fais néant, pas de malaise, je fais néant. Dans l'eau je baigne, c'est l'important, bien à mon aise.
Are you up a mountain road with still a long way to go? Just here. You can see the village just on over the bridge. She said, I'd pulled off to the right to a turning lay-by opposite her turn. She offered me a drink at the local cafe.
La ville grand amour, amour qui commence dans la tour, se poursuit dans les tours, et rime toujours avec toujours. Mais le contexte est plus fort que le concept. Son mec se jette dans des flammes et il se lave avec. Ils sont ensemble, dans les grands ensembles, ensemble. La belle et le bad boy, ils sont ensemble, dans les grands ensembles, ensemble. La belle et le bad boy, ils sont ensemble, dans les grands ensembles, ensemble. La belle et le bad boy, ils sont ensemble, dans les grands ensembles, ensemble. Les sous-ensembles dans les grands ensembles, ça sent, ça sent. Pour gagner des sous ensemble, parle sans faire semblant de faire des coups ensemble. Et si c'est sanglant, il plaide devant Dieu ensemble. Il était convaincant, elle était convaincue à croire. Aujourd'hui s'arrêter était exclu, il trafique. Les faux billets avec des réseaux slap balance la concurrence.
Still had a lot of mountain road to go. And it was going to get dusky before too long. I wasn't loosely trying to race my girlfriend's TGV train from Avignon to Ashford, but she was going to be booking my ferry crossing. I had only just dropped her off after a week of long-anticipated oozes. Le village. Not an excretion.
J'ai la peau douce dans mon bain de mousse. Je bue la l'ombre des bombes.
Sire la luxure, le luxe d'être permanent comme le clan plus luxe. Toi, viens à moi. Tu deviendras explosif comme l'Etna. Agenouille-toi, regarde vers le bas. Agenouille-toi, regarde vers le bas. Vers le sonotone, 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 vers le
sonotone. Tout est délice, délice de si.
I thanked the doctor and said something about me hitchhiking always feeling uncomfortable if I was taking someone out of their way, out of their own journey to facilitate mine, and how it would be getting dark soon. The village vibe was that Alp Maritime, slightly sinister, dark materials in a steep-sided valley that sees the sun only for a few hours of the day, even in summer, rather than sun-baked Provence popping. fucking Legion lavender field that bleaches you violet and pacifist. No other herb. Cafe might well have been the place where we swapped contact details and promised to keep in touch and be best friends forever like the teddy bears. She got out. I pulled away. I never saw her again, as is usual.
La carte à plus remplace le Remington. Mais Harry, à Paris, n'a pas eu de chance. On le stoppe sur le périph' avec sa diligence. Puis on le place à Fresnes, on peut freiner, le freine. Victime des directives de ce que l'on appelle le nouveau western.
Le nouveau western. After, lasted the next half hour in full HD colour and an hour in black and white. The story more dominant in my consciousness than the road. A micro-tells moment from the yes, no, yes that a gambler shows before third gear. She would have accepted me. Taking that drink at the cafe. There was nowhere to turn. River on one side, vertiginous cliffs, straight up. No verge. On the other, I had rejoined the winding snake of traffic. So in full colour, as if a parallel universe projected, like a Eurojet fighter pilot's head-up display, panoramic, across the windscreen.
C'était en vogue. Désormais on les a remplacés par des digicodes. Dans ma ville il n'y avait pas de paramètre. Je voyais des ouvriers manger des sandwichs à l'omelette. Le passé m'en revient comme un pile. Ok, la présence d'un passé omniprésent n'est pas passé. Les halles supplantées par le cost. L'allégorie des madeleines file à la vitesse de Proust. L'air...
Oh si, si, j'ai la peau douce.
She smiled, a woman's knowing smile, which I encouraged into a laugh at me and my procrastination. I declared my undying love for her, or some such, as she climbed in, or back in, and had her at hello, perhaps, or a long suit, or her closing the door behind her. My declaration of admiration continued, and by the time we got the 1 kilometre to the cafe, we found closed. She invited me to her parents.
Hello. de là. Bouge de là. Bouge de là. Bouge de là.
Cabin in the Woods Horror. Agreed, she gave me a toast for a coffee. Her family home was huge, clean, well-appointed, but not a show home. Sylvia, without a stretch, agreed with her parents that it would be, and was, getting dark, that I should stay the night and continue back to my place in the Tarentaise in the morning. It was the air of renting refuge hospitality from someone taking their opportunities and maximising them in the limited amount of career-free time that she had. There was no sense of kiss on the lips. Sat at the kitchen island in front of her parents. She hadn't kissed me before. That kiss communicated to all. He's staying on the sofa in my room. She's an adult. That kiss left me feeling a little used, but catching up in leaps and bounds. On the white leather loafer sofa, two bottles of red between four with the parents, having only a cursory dehydrated ticket clip, she took me up for a shower. I took
dans mon bain de mousse, pas de secousse.
Sat on the toilet seat, handed her a towel as a hand emerged from the sliding screens and steam and was rewarded with a kiss. I glimpsed the side boob story and pinched waist and rounded buttock as she emerged from the fogginess. I stripped my commando-style jeans and beach sand scattering from my scrot, matter-of-factly, functionally, in front of her, in a contextually appropriate level of prudishness, perhaps best described as lack of. I kissed her back and got into the shower myself. I was quick and she was still moisturising on the bed. When I emerged, refreshed, feeling like a new man, we played for an hour, fooled around, then fornicated for an hour, in full medical detail, straight off, which left an hour for fun and cuddles and sentimental reassurances that those thoughts and dreams in the passion were going to be materialised for our future.
Je vous vois en contre-plongée. C'est ceux qui sont déjà partis que je m'en vais retrouver. Ne vous inquiétez pas, non, je pars pour le paradis. Pas au paradis, mais professez la septième prophétie.
We slept 8 hours, had fun for 8 hours, and that left 8 hours for work. And we got to work. Narrowly avoiding... We hardly saw the parents, who were out at work. Days. Days where it was fair to say she was more comfortable roaming nude than I was, especially away from the pool, chopping and preparing lunch from the kitchen garden. Bumblebees look furry, but their erratic flight around my dingly dangles when they are near the courgette flower can have quite a wilting effect. Into almost a week, but days and nights that had come to an end. I dropped her at the train for a return to work in Milan with our future mapped out. I got an email a month later that she was late, tested, and pregnant. Ecstasy. This was all involuntary vision. The last colour I remember was the burgundy of her towel wrapped around her with her tousled wet hair cascading over it in rat's tails. Widescreen on the windscreen.
Devant la glace, elle ausculte son corps, puis crie machinalement encore quelques efforts. Tous les régimes sur elle furent testés. Toutes les tentatives ont été des échecs complets, mais elle persévère et pour plaire à son homme, Dominique a décidé de suivre la norme. Elle en magazine, des magazines dans lesquels le psychopathe trouvait le recours ultime. À la zone de ses formes rondelettes, elle était occupée à couper du thé tout en lui piquant les dosses victimes de la mode. Tel est son nom de code. Victime de la mode. Tel est son nom de code. Lumière, scène de l'as de trèfle lui propose une toute nouvelle donne et en voici la pose. Tellement décoré pour quel résultat? Elle perd de l'oseille au lieu de perdre du poids. Et très vite m'explique qu'elle veut être la réplique d'une créature de clip. Ainsi, on font pour les petites filles coquettes. Elles suivent un modèle qui leur fait perdre la tête. From...
But in reality, by dusk, I was on top of a precipitous pass, looking down over a vast plain. The hairpins fell away more steeply and vertigo-inducing than a fairground ride. To a child, don't look down in the direction of travel and oncoming vehicles. Down was the only way that you could look. Traffic, blinding headlights, and
London, Washington, Kingston, Charenton ou Carcassonne. Quand le téléphone sonne, elle nous répond sans cesse qu'elle était occupée à couper du PQ. Quand lui pique, elle est pacifique. Dis-moi de la mode, tel est son nom de code.
Vertical edge drop. Anticipation observation is normally a good thing. Here, fortunate to find focus on a fender a few feet forward, a friend to follow beyond little tires and tarmac.
J'ai vu la concubine de l'hémoglobine balancer des rafales de balles normales et faire des victimes dans les rangs des descendants d'Adam. C'est accablant, troublant, ce ne sont pas des balles à blanc. On envoie des pigeons défendre la colombe qui avance comme des pions, défendre des bombes.
Le dormeur du Val ne dort pas. Il est mort et son corps est rigide et froid.
Was it foggy or hazy? Hazy. Look around, enjoy the view, this is what you sought. No, don't, it's like a self-induced hazy initiation of the Alps. Focus. What a waste. Down, that cold but it's dark. Don't go. Told myself that I'd been gentlemanly and made another female hitchhiker feel safe. We had a meadow meeting and didn't end with such a lovely Napoleon on his own with a couple of buddies and any swelling of his 1100 une mille une cent well to his rear. He is famously quoted as saying to the 5th Regiment of the line from Grenoble. Soldat, me reconnaissez-vous? Seriez-vous un palais? Vous qui vivez? Tu es son empereur? Moi, voici. The fate of the lowly officer isn't so well recorded by history, when the romantically arrogant challenge railed the enemy policing him to his march to Paris. If I was to see Sylvia again at the same spot and offered myself for life roadside by the same meadow, would she even recognise me? Reunite with me? Ditch the waiter, or spurn and dash the equally magnificent LEF dream? Would we flock together and do the walk? See patois prior, tropicalisation. Once again, would the pretty girl give herself to me or abandon herself to the fickleness of a Lancia driver, to paraphrase Balzac badly? Balzac? You know Balzac?
Bouge de là. Alors j'ai bougé, j'ai dû m'en aller, partir bifurquer, j'ai dû m'évader, j'ai dû m'enfuir, j'ai dû partir, j'ai dû m'éclipser, j'ai dû me camoufler. J'ai dû disparaître pour réapparaître. Oh, bouge de là, bouge de là.
Balzac, a playwright, novelist, La Comédie Humaine, a panoramic of post-Napoleonic life, like widescreen on the windscreen.